What we have covered so far, team, we started with origination. Origination goes to the processing file. From once file is originated, goes to processing. Then from processing, it goes to underwriter.
Underwriting,
very nice. From underwriting, it goes to closing, right?
Closing.
From closing, it goes to funding. And from funding, it goes to, once loan is
shipping.
Borrower got the money, right? What will happen? Borrower got the money. There are two type of funding that we know. One is dry funding, right? And one is wet funding. Now, whatever this closing team, the closer title company that has helped us to close the loan, close the deal, they are going to send file to back to the lender, right? To the lender's office, the documents, the hard copy, right? The copy of recordings, all the documents, those have been signed by all the parties. That file will be sent back to the lender. Now, initially, previously, before closing, we had initial package, right? Initial document package. Then we approved the loan in the underwriting, and after that, a new unsigned, that was not signed, that was unsigned closing package or final package. Closing package or final, because those were the document, those were finalized, but it was unsigned. It was sent to the closer's office, title company office, right? Whoever giving us the title, whoever were helping us to fund the loan, that company received this document, closer received this package, and now that was signed by the borrower, all the documents signed, got closed, got funded. After funding, borrower, after closing, not even funding, after closing, this package with signature of all parties, right? Signed closing package will be sent back to the lender's office. Now your deal is done. Signed closing package. Package is same, but this was unsigned. Now they got signed from borrower, and it will be sent back to who? To the lender's office, right? Now lender will check everything. We will come back to that, why they are going to check it. But always remember, lender always like dry funding. Why? As soon as loan get closed, means all the documents are signed by the borrower and other parties, that file will be, that will be recorded, that loan will be recorded and will be sent back to, the lenders. But after 2 days, once loan is closed, if it's a dry funding, then the loan will, file will be, this signed package will be sent to the lender. So lender will have almost three days to review this package, this signed package, whether all the documents are properly signed, all the documents are complete, all the documents are accurate, right? So accuracy and completeness could be checked within 3 days. After 3 days, borrower will be, or every party will be, funded, or the disbursement of the funds will be happening after 3 days, right? That is for the dry funding. But within these three days, lender can check the entire file. And if there will be anything, any inaccurate information found, any document found not signed, since borrower and all the people are still waiting for the money, if lender, need, lender can easily get signed, or that document could be easily cured, easily corrected, right? But if the same day wet funding will be happening, then that means borrower is going to get the money on the same day. Or whoever the parties are, they will be getting money on the same day. Now, closing happened on the 9th November, and disbursement or funding is also on the 9th November. So borrower got the money, all the parties got the money, and they will go back to their home. Now they receive the money, the deal is closed, right? Now, after this, this file will be sent to lender. And if lender found any inaccurate information, then they need to, you know, chase the every party. And we know if it is not finally, if borrower or whoever, you know, as per the human nature, this happens. If we get borrower get their money, it is very, very, you know, hard, very tough to chase borrower and to get side on the darling. Now, why they want to check, why the lender wanted to check the file for accuracy or for completeness? Because that file need to be sold now, right? They have disbursed the money to every party. Now, lender also need to get funded, also need money. The file need to be sold to someone. Okay. Now, what will happen? Let's say this is the one company. Here is the one. Okay, it's American. Home mortgage. This is the company, lending company, right? Who lended the, who's funding the loan? This American home mortgage company is in California. Okay. Now they have one office in East California. One is in the best California. Okay. One is in the New York. One is in the, this is the one company, one American, you know, American home mortgage company. They have one in East California, one is West California, one is in New York. Okay. One is in the Florida. This is how everywhere they have one in Wisconsin. Okay. That is how. So all these are different offices, but their head office is in California. Okay. Now, maybe in the month of October 2021, East California has funded, this branch has funded 10 loans. Wisconsin, they funded around 5 loans. New York funded around 5 loans, and Florida funded about 10 loans. West California funded 2 loans. So 10 loans, 15, 20, 30, 32 loan total they have funded. 8 loans have been funded in the head office. In this area, they funded 8 loans. So total 10, 15, 20, 30, 32, 8, 40 loans in the entire month they have funded. Now, out of 40 loans, 8 loans are already available in the California office, but rest of the 32 files also will be coming back to head office, right? As soon as those will be funded, closed, those files will be sent to California. Every office will be sending their files to California office, right? So here in the California head office of American Home Mortgage, there will be a shipping counter, right? Who will be receiving all these files. Does that make sense, right? What is happening here? Everyone able to make out? So this is called internal shipping department, right? Internal shipping department. or we can say lender shipping department. First, they will receive all the files from different branches plus whatever the files their own office, head office have funded. All those files will receive in this counter. Like after origination, file was going to AE and AE was submitting it into the submission office. In the similar way, here lender will have a shipping department, and that shipping department will be receiving all the files, right? Will be receiving all the files that has been funded at different branches. Plus, they will also club their files, those have been, you know, funded in the California office. Now 40 files they will receive. What they are this internal shipping department is going to do? First, they are going to, you know, check for completeness and accuracy. I told you completeness plus accuracy, both will be checked in each file, whether what documents are missing. That happens. People who are working in shipping department, they have an extensive checklist or checkpoint, maybe, you know, like 500 checkpoints could be there. They need to check all the documents, and, you know, they have to make sure every document has the accurate information according to the checklist, according to the checkpoints. 500 to 10,000 to 1,000 checkpoints could be there. Okay. Checkpoints could be there. Those need to be checked in these files. Once this shipping department make sure that these files are, let's say 40 files, they are going to check 40 files for the completeness and everything. Once they check these 40 files, whether are complete, accurate, everything is good, then it will be sent to investor delivery department. Now, because all these files have been, you know, funded according to some investors, there could be some prime files, right? There could be some subprime files, right? Subprime files. So prime files will go to either Fannie or Freddie, right? Or whoever their investor is, they will be receiving. It could be Wells Fargo, it could be PennyMac, right? Whoever, they are going to receive all these files. They can even receive these files as well, right? So these files, once checked, now need to be sent to this. Now, most of the time, you know, there are most of the lenders, they are going to, you know, call their processes or the tasks. These are the tasks, those need to be performed. So most of the lenders are going to, you know, going to call the first department who is going to ship the file, right? There are two types of shipping. One is internal shipping, those files are shipped to the head office. Now head office is going to scrutinize these files, going to verify all the accuracy. That is also called a shipping department. So this shipping department receiving these files, right? And then they are checking for completeness and accuracy. Now there is a possibility that the shipping department will also be sending these files directly. There could be some instruction: as soon as you check these files, upload these files into these websites, right? According to instruction. Or there is a possibility they will just check. That happens with many lenders. What they do, they ask the different team, you will only be checking the documents, and once documents are good, you just need to complete that. Okay, shipping done, not shipping, but, you know, verification done, and then you will be fine. The file will be moved from your to someone else. The someone else means it will go to the investor delivery department or investor delivery process. Now they are again going to check, double check, not the extensive checkpoints, but they will be checking, okay, I need to send these many documents to the investor, and there could be a different requirement checkpoint. Like Wells Fargo might give a different documentation you know, I need documentation in this. I need borrower's ID first. I need then 1003, all 1003. I need LD, I need CD. I need then AUS. So that could be the indexing part, right? That need to be done by the delivery department. They will not, delivery department won't be going into the document. This shipping department is going to check whether borrower name is correct or not. All the documents have the similar name, borrower name or not. They might be checking the taxes. They might be checking the, you know, insurance amount. Or they could be, they could check the insurance, you know, invoice is there, all the invoice there, all the appraisal document are there, all the income documents are there. According to the checklist, and they might be checking that, okay, pay stubs belong to borrower or not, everything. But when it comes to the investor delivery, they will not be checking all that micro level information. They will just be indexing document, either going to index, mostly that will be indexed, you know, accordingly, or will be indexed in automatically. But that is what the task. They will be checking all the documents should be in this sequence and they should be there. But they won't be going to the micro level like borrower name is correct and co-borrower name is correct and insurance showing. That will be the shipping department, shipping team or data verification team that will be doing that thing. These team members more focus because they know there are, out of these 40 files, 10 files might be need to send to PennyMac because those have been funded according to PennyMac guidelines. There could be 10 files, those have been funded according to Wells Fargo, so need to be sent to Wells Fargo, right? There could be rest of the 20 files, those might need to be sent to maybe to the Chase, right? So Chase will receive rest of the 20, but everyone will have a different sequence they need. They will have a different, you know, website or a link or a folder there. All those documents need to be uploaded, all 20, one by one, all files need to be uploaded there. That is called investor delivery process or investor delivery department. Is that clear? Both are, you know, these are two steps of shipping department, of shipping. Okay, are we good?
Yes.
It is, the entire department is the shipping department. They are receiving the files from internal branches. Then they are sorting out all the documents, all the files, and then, you know, they will be checking one by one all the documents on a micro level. Then they are going to perform the delivery task as well. But most, according to my knowledge, I haven't seen that happens very less. Very less if there are very, you know, small number of, or it's the lender is very small, who will have only 10 files in the entire month, those will be funded. Or they, if there will be only one branch, or even there will not be any branch, and they could have only 10, 6 to 8 files only in the entire month, or 3, 4 files. Obviously, they are not going to make it different, but steps are different. Those need to be performed. First, someone need to go through the entire file. They need to receive the file, they need to go through the file, they need to sort which file need to be sent to PennyMac, which file need to be sent to Wells Fargo, which need to be chased, and they also need to make sure the file, you know, gets uploaded to their websites properly, and accurate files gets uploaded into the accurate website. So all these files, electronic files, will be sent to the investors, whoever going to purchase these files will be sent to them as an investor delivery process, and within 90 days. So this first step is for the electronic files. All the documents, those are available in our LOS, right? Those will be sent through LOS only, mostly to these investors. But the hard copies, right, the original copies which have been signed by the parties, all parties, so hard copies of these loan files also need to be sent to the whoever going to purchase this file, right? So within 90 days, hard files of loans will also be sent to will also be sent to investors. Okay, first we are going to send, our investor delivery team is going to send the electronic files, right? And then with once electronic file sent, within 90 days, the hard file copy through the email, not how we can send email. Email means electronic mail, right? But through the physical mail. So only through the mails, it need to be sent, physical mail, through the post mails, right? So these hard copies also need to ship as or need to mail to the borrowers. Done. Any question related to shipping? What happens in the shipping? Once these are shipped, especially the electronic file shipped, because this hard file will be taken internally. It could only be done internally. No one can, it cannot be outsourced, right? We cannot first ask someone to send these hard files through the post to India and then we will outsource it. We will send back to the Wells Fargo. That is not going to happen. So it will be just a physical thing that need to be done only in the office. So what after that, once the file is shipped to the lender, right, to the investors, right, we will be sending that file within the 90 days and that's it. Lender is done. Once file is sent, now there is entire a new cycle will start after the shipping. Whoever the investor is going to receive the file, almost similar, you know, once the file is through the closing, now it is going to be the post-closing department, right? Post-closing department. Everything happening will be considered post-closing because closing is done. File is dead. I mean, we know that. Until the file is live, we can make changes. Once the file is closed, borrower got the money, no change could be done in, no one can go back and give a life to the file, right? It is dead, okay? So everything is going to be offline now. Offline means it is going to be the post-closing.